AMD RX 6000 series is here! An AI that detects Voronacryrus! Spotify not increased price, whoa! Don't go anywhere, this is MLM! Well, we promised that we will cover the all-new AMD Radeon RX 6000 series graphics card, so we will keep to that promise, and here we go. The first one we have is the all-new Radeon RX 6800 XT. It comes with 22 compute units, a game clock of up to 2050MHz, and a maximum boost clock of 2250MHz. Priced at $649, which is $50 cheaper than the RTX 3080, AMD claims that the 6800 XT can go head-to-head with RTX 3080. Well, can't wait to see third-party benchmarks. Next, the Radeon RX 6800 is priced at $579, and since it is not directly going against RTX 3070, it is priced at $80 more expensive. Also, it comes with 60 compute units and slightly lower frequencies than the 6800 XT, but according to AMD, it outperforms the RTX 2080 Ti by quite a bit when compared to the RTX 3070, which performs just about the same as the 2080 Ti. If this card can offer enough performance over the RTX 3070, it will definitely be a hot seller. Finally, Lisa Su went for the bigger kill and pulled out a huge card out from her pants. It is the RX 6900 XT. Nice. Its frequency is the same as the RX 6800 XT, but with 80 compute units instead of 72. Oh, did I mention that this card can trade blows with the RTX 3090, which costs $1,499? And guess how much is the 6900 XT? It is $999! Wait, what? Just take my money already! All three variants come with a 16GB GDDR6 memory. A very nice touch. And if you want to find out more about the benchmarks, just simply head over to AMD's website. Lastly, here are the features that will come with the new graphics cards. Number 1. AMD Smart Access Memory. A technology that will take advantage of your Ryzen 5000 series CPUs and 500 series motherboard to give you more FPS in game. Is this a sign to build a full-on Team Ray gaming PC? Number 2. Rage Mode. Rage Mode is a one-click overclocking tool that allows you to squeeze out extra performance from your graphics card automatically. Number 3. Infinity Cache. Not Infinity Cache. But anyway, Infinity Cache is a technology that enables higher bandwidth without increasing the memory bus or the power consumption. What do you guys think? We cannot wait for the local pricing and see how this new 6000 series will fare against competitors. What a good time to be alive as a gamer, right? Wow! Wait, Ilian showed me the link to this phone. I was kind of starstruck. It is shiny, it is bold, it is the OnePlus 8T Cyberpunk 2077 edition. So, of course the design is gonna be unique, especially the back of the phone. The front of the phone still kind of looks like the standard 8T model. What I really dig are the yellow accents along the edges and Cyberpunk's logo at the bottom. But what I don't fancy is the camera bump. I feel like it doesn't need to be there. It would be much cooler if they put in some LED details. What do you guys think? I mean, still gotta give it to them lah. The whole look and feel of the phone design really does scream Cyberpunk 2077! While there really isn't much of a difference between the standard 8T and this special edition model, it still sports the Snapdragon 865 processor with a 4500mAh battery that can be fast charged using a Warp 65 charger. The display is still the same 120Hz 6.55 inches AMOLED display. It comes with 12GB of RAM and 256GB of storage. This special edition model is also priced slightly more expensive at 3,999 renminbi. So why did I convert renminbi to RM? That is because this phone is only available in China.
Sad that Cyberpunk 2077 is delayed again? Don't be too sad because MOBHouse is doing a collab with Cyberpunk. Pre-order the game before 30th November and you'll get exclusive MOBHouse edition merchandise including a Cybershane t-shirt at the same price as the digital copy. So what are you waiting for? Check out the link in the description below.
Cough, cough. We all know we sound different when we cough. There's the acute cough, something stop cough, kind of choke cough, and ugly cough. MIT researchers have discovered that those who are asymptomatic to COVID-19 will cough differently to those who are not. Unfortunately, these coughs are not apparent to human ears. The team at MIT collected first cough recordings of asymptomatic people which were submitted voluntarily through web browsers and devices such as smartphones and laptops. Then they trained an AI model to distinguish asymptomatic people from healthy individuals by creating an AI framework that consists of three pre-existing algorithms. The first algorithm algorithm will test how strong or weak your vocal cords are, and the second algorithm will identify all the emotional states evident in your speech, and the third algorithm will test any changes in your breathing and lungs performance. So when you combine all these three neural networks, what you get is a new AI framework for your AI model to train on. And the result is rather shocking. The AI model accurately identified 98.5% of calls from COVID-19 positive patients and 100% calls from asymptomatic people. They are currently working on incorporating the AI model into an app for people to check if they are asymptomatic to COVID-19. All you need to do is cough into your phone and you will get an instant result. Hopefully, FDA will approve lah, huh? And also make it free. LOL fans, I have something exciting for y'all. Rune King, a LOL story, is a single player LOL spin-off that will be arriving early next year to consoles such as Nintendo Switch, PS4, and Xbox One. PS5 and Xbox Series S or X will also be getting the game by much later lah. And not to forget, the game will also be available on Steam and Epic Games Store. The game will be set in the Bilgewater and Shadow Isles regions of Runeterra with some playable characters from LoL. They are Miss Fortune, Illaoi, Braum, Yasuo, Ahri, and Pyke. The release of Rune King will be the first release by Riot Games' new indie publishing label, Riot Forge. Are you excited to see the expansion of LoL universe into different games and different genres? Have you guys tried Wild Rift or Legends of Runeterra yet? If you have, let us know more about it in the comments down below. Spotify users, I'm very sorry to break the bad news to you, but the CEO of Spotify, Daniel Ek, has just confirmed that they will be increasing the price for their subscription plans. And here is why. Number one, according to the CEO, the company is not making good money even when they have 144 million active paying users a month. Number two, Spotify is always bringing new content for their users, such as number one, their ever-growing content library world. Number two, a new podcast tool that allows users to add licensed music into their podcast. The CEO believes that by increasing the price, the company can pull in higher revenue from countries that the company believes users will see the value in paying for their subscription service. And Michelle's Chan's turn. They are betting on their users' loyalty lah, right? If let's say you have been using Spotify for 6 to 7 years, you won't mind paying for the RM4 to RM5 increment, right? Right? I, for one, think that it would be great if they can come up with a plan where users can choose what kind of features they want to enjoy and pay accordingly. Or Spotify can roll initiatives to promote paying features to non-paying users and convert them into paying users. Not Robert's Law, hello! The non-paying users, they may have to go through the torture of ads, but hello, they still can listen to music, right? They can still listen to the full-length version of songs they want to listen to, right? At least cut down verse 1 and the ending of song, only let them listen to chorus now since they're not paying for it. Walao eh, I feel so robbed. Comments time! Amp Edition. Intel set pathetic cry for attention because AMD is in the spotlight like a boss. Only blah 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 blah. Yes, I gotta agree with you. I mean, we all gotta agree, right? That AMD definitely beats Intel in terms of competitive pricing and also performance. Ben's Gaming, I love your vibes, Michelle. Keep it up! Thank you. Next, Wee Senpai. Michelle really cute with the new haircut. K, bye. Thank you, K, bye. Daniel Fonseca. Michelle, I love the haircut in Brazilian. I would like to know two things. Which smartphone do you use? And in Malaysia, which smartphone brand dominates the market? I prefer iPhone to Android because iPhone for me is more minimalistic. It is very simple and very straightforward. I know back in those days, a lot of functions cannot be carried out by the iPhone. It's very limited, but now it's 2020 already, okay? Finally, we can transfer files from A to B. Vihari Royal. Those 90Hz displays drain the batteries very quickly, back to 60Hz in no time. But what if the battery size big, maybe can, I don't know. Actually, I don't know a lot about phone specs. Moi Chi Hui, I don't want to come out with t-shirt like Cyberpunk, Cyber Michelle, or Cyber Elaine. It's not that we don't want to, it's that we have no budget because y'all never buy Cyber Shane shirts. So without income, we don't have money to come up with new merchandise. Okay guys, please remember to follow my personal page also. I need to boost my followers and likes so that I can get more jobs from clients and show you guys more content. Okay, so I guess that is all for today's MLM. Oh wait, before I end, I want to say this, okay. So recently, one of my viewers, he contacted me on Instagram and he's from the Philippines. So he was asking me, what does War mean? Okay, let me give you a very quick Malaysian slang 101 class. You add war to the end of a sentence when it is something fishy or something that you think is not right. Okay, for example, I tell you I am a white girl. So you can go and tell your friend, hey, Michelle says she's white. War. Okay, that's how I make the face. Okay, anyway, that's all I have for today. I hope you enjoyed today's MLM video. See you guys in the next episode. Bye!